Yo, everybody. When the Eagles decided to go out and get a franchise quarterback, I was all for it. Because, as they said, a franchise quarterback would bring stability to the position, which would bring stability to the offense, which would bring stability to the team. I bought it hook, line, and sinker. And as the offseason this year began, I was excited to see what they would do. Because I know adding pieces to a young franchise quarterback would be significant in our goals of winning a Super Bowl and being a contender year in, year out. Somewhere along the line, the Eagles veered off that road. And they decided that their true colors were, they were more concerned about the appearance of winning a Super Bowl next year than building team the right way. So they went out and they signed Alshon Jeffrey to a one-year deal. A one-year deal for what? Now, there are two types of people. There are the people who think that it's important, the only thing that matters is the year that's coming up. And if you believe that, you're happy about Alshon. Then there are those that believe you build for the next 10 years, and you build a team that will compete every year with a legitimate shot to win the Super Bowl. I fall in that line. Now, what the Eagles did today was completely the opposite line of thinking for what they did last year in getting wins. Both different type of philosophies don't work together. They don't work, okay? They signed Alshon Jeffries to a one-year deal, right? Then they got Torrey Smith to a three-year deal, which is actually 3 one-year deals, I believe. So he's basically on a one-year deal. Jeffries on a one-year deal. We now have a situation where our quarterback will go into his third year with possibly his third group of new wide receivers. When this kind of instability happens, most of the time it results in your franchise quarterbacks never living up to their talent. They become busts. Because players become busts not just because they are bad or because they're choke artists or whatever. A lot of times it has to do with the front office and the organization around that player. So what the Eagles did today was they treated Carson Wentz like he is Tom Brady or he is Big Ben that has been in the league for 5-6 years that can play with new receivers at a whim because he knows what he's doing. That's not true. He's still learning. He still needs to grow. He still needs to learn how to produce and learn how to play. They're working on his mechanics this year. He has a lot of things going on, and now they're going to throw new receivers at him. And anybody that thinks that this Alshon is just 1 year deal and then he'll re-sign with the Eagles, I don't believe it. As far as I'm concerned, he's on a 1 year deal. So the Eagles have completely dismantled what their plan was last year to go on this idea that they're going to improve for next year and make a run at what? The playoffs? I mean, the Giants signed Brandon Marshall to a 2 year deal. Eli Manning's won 2 Super Bowls. He is at the end of his career. Wentz is at the beginning of his career. And you're already throwing new players in and out of him. They're doing the same thing with a franchise quarterback. This is ridiculous. This is really, really dangerous. And I think this will cost Howie Roseman his job and maybe Peterson as well. This is really dumb, okay? I want stability around Wentz. I want you to bring in players who will be there for a while. It doesn't matter if one guy is better than the other guy. That's not what it's always about. It's about getting ascending players that will fit for the next 5 to 10 years with him. It's not about who's the best player for next year. And the Eagles are showing that's what they think. Not only
when it
that
comes to the draft,
I don't believe the Eagles will sit there and go and take and take a wide receiver in the first pick with the 14th overall pick. I don't believe they'll take a running back. I believe they're going defense, they're going primary defense, and that's the way it's going to be. And not only that, but they have just made it known to the whole league that if you need a defensive back or a defensive end, you got to jump the Eagles because that's what they're going to take. They're so predictable. It's not even funny. It's horrible. I don't think they know what the hell they're doing. It's amateur hour. And the only team, as far as I'm concerned, that is actually worse than us and does stupider things is the Cleveland Browns. That's it. Because they make no sense either. I mean, get young guys and build around Wentz. Put guys there that will be with him for his career. I just can't believe that they're so stupid. And I'm sorry. If you don't agree with me, that's your right. That's your right. But I'm willing to bet that you're going to be coming to me later on during the season going, you're right. What the hell did Howie do? That's what I think. Till next time.